Yeah, today we are at Gerard and Bas Verkerk in the Racing Loft. These are your hands here?
We have three sections of hands. This is one of them. They are separated now for 2 weeks after they have had youngsters. And now, since 2 weeks, they train almost every day. When the weather is good, they go outside.
Okay. So they had youngsters. When did you pair them?
Now, we have paired them the first week of January, because that was the same date for the second round of the eggs of the breeders. So the racers had the second round of the breeders in their nest.
Okay. And did they had eggs afterwards, or did you separate the birds when they were still on youngsters?
Normally we separate them when the youngsters are 17, 18 days before they get eggs. But I have to... The hens need to find the loft of the cocks. So that's the reason I kept them for another week together. They can fly out together for 1 week. So 3 times they went out together. So they know now the section of the cocks. And now, until the season starts, they fly out from the hens loft.
Okay. So, can you tell us something about the caretaking now? Did they had any medical treatments or something else during the time they had youngsters or before you made them? And how will the coming weeks be?
Now, before the breeding starts, we did all the vaccinations. So in October we did salmonella vaccination. In the end of November we did paramyxovirus vaccination, and a few weeks before pairing, so it was the middle of December, we did the pox vaccination. We did not treat them against trigo or anything else, but we will visit the veterinarian before racing, and when they check a few and they check the droppings, and when they find something, we cure. Otherwise, we don't cure.
Okay. So that's different than about 10 or 20 years ago. Then you did more medical treatments, but nowadays it's not necessary anymore, and the birds can
also bring youngsters without any cure. But when they are sick or not good, then we visit the veterinarian and we give something. And during the season, we give every 4 weeks or 5 weeks, we give a treatment against trigo.
Yes, that's in fact basically your system, because you don't do anything else during the season.
No.
And can you tell us something about your feeding? Because I see a little bit of corn inside the feeding trails, but is it extra light now, or is it...
At the moment it's 50-50. So what the leftover of this morning, so that was 6-7 ago, so there's a little bit of barley now on the floor, and that is left over from this morning. Mm-hmm. So we feed them in 2 hours again, and there is always a little bit leftovers. So, but it's 50-50 light, 50 sport.
Okay. And then when the season starts, you from the first week on, you will to feed the birds heavier at the end of the week. Eh? So starting at the first race. You don't keep the feed light until the middle distance or something.
No, every week the same. So short, middle, 1 day long distance. So when they come home, they can choose what they like. So that's a lot of sports mixture. And then Sunday, we start with the Verkerk Light of Beyers. And then every day we increase the sports percentage until the end of the week. So with middle distance, 1 day long distance, with Thursday basketing, so Thursday is the last day, and with short distance is Friday, the last feeding day in the loft.
And so that counts for as well the cocks as the hens, huh? So
the cocks, hens, and also when the young bird season starts, also for the young birds.
Yes. And what else do the birds get except water and feed? You give them minerals, I see. Do you have special minerals, or is it always the same?
We have a mineral mix since a month from DAP. There's a mixture of seeds, tofu, minerals together in grit stones, and that every loft here get that every day fresh. So what the leftovers we throw away, and they get new in a pot, mm-hmm. and then every day also the breeders, the retirement home, all pigeons get fresh every day.
Okay, so minerals are very important. Other byproducts are not that important.
We give twice a week. We give Probac 1000 from Brokamp together with Fortevita of Trifi Pharma into the water. So during the winter season, we give that on Sunday and Wednesday, and in the racing season on Sunday and Monday. So probiotics, acids, herbs. Mm-hmm. So maybe it helped, maybe it's. But Fortevita we give already, I think, 30 years. Mm-hmm. So it's a good product, I think.
Okay. Can we also look at your cocks?
Yeah, maybe? There's on the other side.
Other side. How many sections do you have for the cocks?
We have 5 sections for the cocks. We have for racing this year, we have a little bit more hands than cocks. So a few cocks without a ship ring, we don't race this year. So we have normally we have 5 sections with 24 cocks. Most of them are yearlings. And this one is then 3 years old and a few of 2 years old. So we raised them on total widowhood. So also 2 weeks ago we separate them, and now they fly out separate from the hens.
Is that the first time you have more hens than cocks to raise?
No, that is what our yearlings, almost all our yearlings get a chance to compete as an old bird. So it depends on how is the selection after the young bird season is over. And last year we had more hens. So we had also in the past a little bit more cocks, but last year we had more hens left.
And what's your favorite for this year?
I hope with this number of pigeons I have a little bit more. But a favorite. It's difficult to say. I think the number 462. There was a hen that every time I come into the loft that I see, it's a favorite pigeon. But not in the handle, but more the that I look into the loft that I see. Oh, that can maybe a good one.
So. Yeah. What do you see?
Last year I had a good choice, but I lost in the race before last. That was National Ace Pigeon. But that was also, as a youngster already, I saw that was a good one. But the other one, Ace Pigeon last year, that was Sam, and did in the winter time, and didn't see that became a good one. So, but it's a 29, unforgettable. I had a feeling for that pigeon.
Okay.
At the moment, they have every day when they fly out, they have a lot of stress from the attacks from the sparrowhawk. They don't want to fly out of the aviary, so I have to force them to go out.
But how many times do you release them each day? Once a day?
Yeah. Now we with good weather they train once a day. With wind like today, I keep them inside because they have muscle problems with the wings, or muscles, what it is, but they fly.
The scale figures. Yes, we don't know the English words.
So that's the reason I keep them inside with this kind of wind.
Yeah. So. And so your father was also. A bit stressed when he sees the hawk.
Yeah,
I noticed.
But so we hope it gets less in a few weeks, and then they can train normally, and they can, because I think to get pigeons in a top condition, they I think they don't need stress, because to get them in a good form, I think that's very difficult.
Okay, but did you experience these kind of problems with sparrowhawks before? So in previous years, you also had the problem, they didn't want to go out and everything.
But it's now the past few weeks, it's very difficult, but in the every year we have problems with attacks from hawks, and but I think in the in a few weeks I hope it's getting less, and they get more relaxed, that they get come into a good condition.
And then you start releasing them twice a day, starting in May or something.
No, first now they are on the darkening method, so they are since they are the youngsters. Separated, they are now in 10 days on the darkening method, so that is 14 hours a day is dark until the 1st of May, and after that we start when the weather is good enough in the morning, we train them also in the morning and in the afternoon, and now only in the afternoon.
Can we also take a look at your young birds?
Yeah, of course. They are outside in the aviary, the second round.
Now here we are in your young bird loft. These are the winter youngsters. Can you tell me, Bas, how many rounds of youngster do you breed?
We breed 4 rounds of youngsters from our breeders, and 2 rounds of our best racers. And these have already had 2 vaccinations. So Paramyxo and Paramyxo together with Rota.
And do they get more vaccinations later?
Only when all the youngsters are weaned, we vaccinate against pox.
And your old birds are also vaccinated against Salmonella, but the young birds are...
No. So far we didn't vaccinate them yet.
And do these birds get special treatments, or is it the same as with the old birds?
Same as the old birds, but so when they get problems, we visit the veterinarian or the Domien and Jan from De Weert or Stefan Geubel from Geubel van de Sluis. And when there's something wrong with respiratory or trigo, we give something, but so far they didn't get any treatment yet.
And the feeding of the young birds, can you tell us something about that?
Now, at the moment all the youngsters, they get breeding mixture. Together with Tovo, small seeds, and a few peanuts and P40. But and the same like the old birds with the ProBuck and the Fortevita twice a week. So, and when all the youngsters are together, then we give light and sport.
And how many percentage light feed do they get then?
It depends how they are training at home, but also I think 60-70% sport mixture.
Okay, 30% light.
But I think it's also important that the pigeons grow very well, so I think too much light I think is not good for later on to develop their body.
So these birds are already flying around the loft?
Yeah, these normally they are sitting on the aviary, but this year the winter youngsters flying, so that's for us it's in progress. So
But last year was also better, I believe.
Yeah, it's getting better year by year, I hope so.
And how does that come, do you think?
Now more attention, and the last 3 or 4 years we do winter breeding again, so that also the last round, in the past we weaned the last youngsters the end of May, and now about 10th or 15th of April is finished, because the last youngsters are hatching now, and then in the aviary the second round youngsters is now, and the third round is about 18 days at the moment.
Okay. So then you're also ready soon. And then when you start training them?
When all fly good at home, so that will be the end of May, I think. Then we start with short distance to train them. But before the first race, our help on Saturday, Sil van Vliet, we'll put them some Saturdays into the basket with water to learn and to get less stress in the basket.
Okay. So it costs us a lot of attention, of course, young bird raising, when you want to do it well.
Yeah, I think everything what you want to do well, it's if it's short distance, long distance, marathon, it get a lot of attention. So only a handful of food and watching how they come home, I think it's to be on top of the list is very difficult, I think.
Well, Das, thank you very much for this conversation.
Oh, yeah, thank you, and enjoy watching.